I don't want people hurt. I know what it means to be hurt. I don't want people hurt. And you can, everything that's truth that's pushed to extreme becomes heresy, becomes harmful. So I don't want to say no to anybody. I want to be able to add something to everybody. But, you know, that in itself can push you into pride. You can't do that. So because you want to help everybody, you keep saying yes and yes. But you must recognize your limitation. Your limitation as a person. And that's why we must synergize. I must know where my ability stops. I must know where my limitation begins. So my being able to say no, at the time I should say yes, it's also my allowing another person the space to do whatever God has called them to do. So take it this way, we are four, mm-hmm. and we're gifted differently.
Mm-hmm.
I keep saying no, yes. I say yes to what you're supposed to do. I say yes to what the third man is supposed to do. I say yes to what the fourth man is supposed to do. So what will they do now? I must believe that when I say no, I am giving you opportunity to say yes.
Mm.
And that in itself should help me say a no and not always say yes.
Mm.
Then the other part is, I say it this way, you're not Jesus that died for the world. If they give you opportunity to die on the cross, you will come down. You're also supposed to say, I will die with him, I die with him when my, leave me burial day, no burial day. I will die. Mm. I will die. Leave them, they will not die.
Mm.
They will not even enter. Fear will not even allow them to enter the grave. That day they had the opportunity to enter so we can cover them. So all that, I will die with him, is because somebody is holding them. They will not die. So I realize I'm not Jesus that died for the world. I know sometimes, as you grow anyway, you see yourself saying a lot of yes as you're growing up. But as you start growing, you see your energy level is no longer the same.
Mm.
Your responsibility is not increasing. Some dependents are increasing. Your immediate cycle, persons are you're responsible for, start increasing. So you begin to learn how to say no, but in love. It's learning how to say no in love. So if you can learn how to say no, like I said sometime earlier when we were talking, Moses was able to get to a place where he divided the Red Sea, where the 10 miracles happened, because there was a primary no he said in his life.
Mm.
And it was the reason, first reason he was really put in that chapter of Heroes of Faith.
Yeah,
he said no to the pleasures of Egypt. They are not things you say no easily to.
Yeah,
he said no, and that no opened up the door for other miracles in his life. Which means there are some no's you will say that will now open the doors to a lot of yeses. That would be a blessing.
True.
But if you miss the initial no's that set boundaries in your life, there will be no you. There must be a shepherd that has a life to lay down.
Mm.
So a good shepherd lays down his life. It's not a good shepherd lays down no life. So if they take all the life, what will you lay down? And that place Paul says in Acts 20, Paul said, take heed of yourselves, then of the flock. We must first of all have a life. He says, present your life a living sacrifice, not a dead sacrifice. So I must be able to know my limitation. Know that even my no will preserve some relationship. Like an example, you come to ask me for money. I don't have that money to give to you. I can borrow it from somebody to give to you. So there are three relationships now. You are asking me for money, then me that's giving the money.
Mm-hmm.
And then the person I'm borrowing the money from. The person is giving money because the person trusts me. So I take the money and I give to you.
Mm-hmm.
And then you don't pay me back. Because I couldn't say no. So what will happen is that when I now ask you for that money, you will not be able to pay me back. My relationship with you is destroyed. And then the person I borrowed money from that trusts me, be abused for 10 years, will be destroyed because I couldn't say no. My no could have preserved my relationship with you. So that's a lot of no's that we must learn to say. But in love, I said, in love means you're following 1 Corinthians 13. You're patient, you're kind, you're putting yourself in the person's place. You're looking at how to say, you're saying it nicely, but you're actually saying no to save your life and to save their own lives.
True. And there's something you said. You said no can serve as discipline for you.
Mm-hmm.
where you deny yourself of some pleasures. You say no to something.
If you don't,
and that opens the door for more yeses.
Yes, yes. If you don't do that, if you don't learn how to say that no, okay, this is the ministry of self-control. And in it, you have what we call lasciviousness or incontinency, inability to control yourself.
Wow.
So this goes deeper. First of all, we can't forget who we are. We are here as disciples of men. We are here to help men find God's purpose for their life, fulfill it. So it starts from, first of all, them meeting with God, and then we are here to help them. Two things always happen. When you meet with God, then there are persons to work with you to help you fulfill what God told you when you met him. Because every time you meet God, he will tell you what he wants you to do. He always does that.
Beautiful.
That's why you call him Lord.
Beautiful.
That's why you say, wherever I come under your authority. Mm. But it's going to also put you under the authority of some persons who are going to come to help you. Now, once he begins to tell you what to do, he begins to chart a path for you. That is what we popularly call a vision, a plan, a purpose, heart of God, mind of God, purpose of God, blueprints of God, whatever you call it. I'm saying all these words so that you will not miss what I'm saying.
Okay.
Once he begins to do that, that in itself comes with a lot of no's. It means that whatever that does not fit this thing he's telling me,
dropped.
No. And the no is a no. Mm. It's not I'm going to check.
Mm-hmm.
It means this no is no.
Yes.
This N is capital N.
Yes.
And this O is is with echo. It's echoing
yes.
all the time. And it is who I am. It is not changing. It can never change. That sets my boundary. Now, I don't just say that no. I begin to now build a mechanism, a system to protect that no.
Beautiful.
Before you can even reach the no, I don't build fence. I'm sorry, I have built plenty of fence. You know how it is if you want to enter, like Aso Rock,
yes.
any place that has top security.
Yes.
You don't just say you're trying to kill a governor. Mm. Where, how did you get there?
Exactly.
For you to now know whether you can kill him or not. So they are stopping you.
Mm.
So that no is that I'm going to say that's going to protect what God told me to do with my life. I'm going to build a system around it.
Mm.
That system should be people.
Okay.
What we call accountability.
Okay.
Or submission circle. What we call a cabinet. Proverbs 14:28. In the absence of a people, it's the destruction of any prince. So first, it's your vision that helps you to say no.
Mm.
You gather self-control and lasciviousness begins to fall. Inability to control yourself begins to fall away.
Mm.
But it needs to be clear that I heard. That man must have an encounter that he heard that produces a deep conviction, a deep persuasion. It shows in his eyes, in his gait. That is what he lives for.
Mm.
That is something he's willing to die for.
Mm.
So the no is very loud. If you're coming there to do anything aside this thing, everything is saying no to you. His eye is saying no. His presence is saying no. We are not going there. The second thing he now does is that persons begin to come into your life who you can now tell the vision, who have been called to help you. And this is how I would want to express these persons. One, they have to love the same God that told you to live a particular way.
Okay.
Two, they have to love you. If they don't love him, they can't love you. Man's love is selfish. It's only agape love that is unconditional.
True.
Every other love. So they need to love God first to be able to love you. Three, they need to at least understand the values of a kingdom, know scriptures. And four, they need to be spiritual enough to understand the uniqueness of what God has called you, the season of your life. What that thing that's making you think that you're running with. Now, when you explain the process to them, this is who I am, this is what I want to live for, they become an accountability circle. So when you now say
an accountability
no,
circle.
Yes, that's when you now say no, it is not only you that's saying no. You have three people, four people that are saying no with you, which means somebody gives you an offer. You are not sure because there are some offers. Because once God begins to define the thing, help you define what he wants you to do, you know it. The only way the enemy can now stop you is through lies, deception, manipulation, control. And these things can be strong.
Yes.
To get you to say yes to what you should say no, which means getting you to say a yes when you intended to say no.
Mm.
So they will use all manners of craft to come in. MSC, manipulation, control, seduction. Once that happens, if you're in a company that you've submitted to, it's always impossible for Satan to deceive you into yes when you should say no, and then deceive those people.
Yes.
So what happens is that you're able to say, can I get back to you on this matter? You call the persons. Nobody will know. and say, this is the offer I'm getting. What do you think? What do you think? Because we're all gifted differently. That's why God brought you to a team. There's a blind side. There's an infirmity that all of us have. You can't run away from the fact that you are not infinite.